have here the mechanical perfusion gun. I'm going to go through disassembly and reassembly, starting with the fluid section. We've got to kind of take this off in stages and then reverse the process. So I'll go through a couple of tips and tricks along the way. So we're going to remove the air cap, the tip retainer, and the tip. Just going to loosen the front packing module retainer. So the mixed module's here. Usually that module's stuck, so we'll have to put the air to the gun and use the valving rod to assist in kind of jacking that out of there. You see how it already, a couple of the triggers, usually you'll do the trick. So we can remove the mix module. And we can remove the fluid head retainer. And we can use our spin tight nut driver that came with the gun to remove the rear packing. The front packing and the rear packing are the same part number. Just use the valving rod to help extract the retainer. So we have the inlet check valves and screens. There's a resin side and one that's not marked. And then we have the ISO side, or the A. And the A side components, as you can see, they're all marked A. They're machined the same. The only difference is we label them. We want to keep the parts separate. So we can go ahead and remove the O-rings. We're going to get all these O-rings in the kit. If you buy a genuine Graco part kit, you're going to get all the proper O-rings. And the O-rings will actually have a dot on them. You can see the red dot there. They're designed for the high temperatures and the chemicals that we work with when we're processing the chemicals that are for either a coating or foam. Same thing on the A side. Again, we're going to keep those parts separate. So that's the fluid section. We can get into the air section if it needs service. We can remove the rear cap and safety stop. If the red band is showing, that means the gun is engaged. The band is hidden, that means the safety is on. We have the O-rings on the air piston. And there's a spring that holds the tension on the purge rod, and also an O-ring there. So we want to make sure that we replace this O-ring. It's also in the kit. Valve rod over there. We're going to make sure that valve rod is nice and clean and there's no burrs. We don't really want to use a razor blade on this because it'll tear up your mix module and your packings. So we just want to soak that and clean it with maybe a really light Scotch-Brite. And we want to keep that nice and shiny and without nicks or burrs. You can see that spring that just holds the tension against the threads to keep the rod in the proper adjustment. So this will have the O-ring here for the face because we have clean off air that I didn't remove. It's like a needle valve assembly. There's a small O-ring there that blows air across this cap to keep material from adhering to the cap while we're in sprayer process. So then all that's left is this air input. We have a spring. There's a cutaway in the handle here to press back the air spool. The air spool has three small O-rings. Be careful when we take these off that we don't scratch the spool. It'll leak air. So we have the exhaust muffler. If your gun is working sluggishly or if it fails to trigger at all, a lot of times it's this bronze exhaust muffler gets contaminated with your air supply, rust and dust. You want to make sure that's good and clean. You can soak that in a little bit of solvent and blow that off and make sure everything's clean and clear. You can see that we have all the air passageways. All of these passageways can be accessed straight on with the exception of the one that goes down through the center. We have to remove this plug and then we can gain access to that hole. And there's the one to the front for the clean-off air. And that gun is pretty much broken down. We'll get everything cleaned up and back together then.